One and only Mr. Lacy Van Zant, or better known as Papa V by Skynyrd fans. This past October 1999, while attending the Freebird Foundation picnic weekend, we stopped by the Van Zant home to take a picture outside. Imagine our surprise to be invited inside by Lacy himself. It was a great pleasure to meet Lacy and Marion Van Zant. And it was also unbelievable to see all the gold and platinum albums and all the attributes to their son's successes. But I think the greatest joy that we got was realizing that we were under the same roof where Ronnie, Donnie, Johnny, and the various Van Zant sisters were raised. You see, after their three sons became successful, the Van Zants probably had many opportunities to move to maybe a bigger house, perhaps a nicer neighborhood. But I think it says it all about who they are that they chose to stay in the home that Lacy built for his bride. I think that Lacy was Ronnie's biggest influence in life and made Ronnie the man that he became. The old-fashioned values that he instilled in Ronnie influenced his songwriting later and gave him those down-to-earth lyrics, I think. He mentioned his dad various times in song, always talking about what his daddy taught him. He even wrote a song about his father, Truck Driving Man. I think that Lacy is probably Ronnie's earliest musical influence. Ronnie would spend his summers traveling up and down the eastern seaboard with his dad. See, his dad was a trucker, and he always had his radio tuned in to that AM country. Ronnie was influenced by Merle Haggard and various other country stars of the day. And I think that's where he got his storytelling craft to his songwriting, was his country influences. He mixed that with the rock and roll that he grew up to love and made that mix that created Lynyrd Skynyrd. It was also a pleasure to meet Marion Van Zant. It's sort of bittersweet talking about this because this past spring, Mrs. Van Zant passed away. Listen closely for her comment about how much fun we were going to have at the Freebird Foundation picnic the next day.
You got it, Baylor. We're here, man. We're here. Now pan that ocean, man. Show them how close we are.
Hey, where we at, dudes?
We're at the hotel for Skynyrd, man. We are the fans.
Jacksonville!
We're here for Ronnie. We're here for my name, little girl. What's your name?
Why don't you come upstairs, bitch, and have a drink of champagne? Oh, man, what's your name, little girl? What's your name? Shooting you straight, little girl. What's your
your name.
If it's a small, sweet thing,
shouldn't you stay? Little girl, could you do the same?
Oh, come on.
Jack, what am I doing?
The smell that's around.
Oh, that's it.
That's Maryland.
That's fucking, you know, where Maryland
okay,
is.
Guys, listen, only one person talking. Only one person talking.
I've seen him before at the stairs.
Well, you go ahead and talk all you want, Bubba.
John, that's okay. A guy who loves
you. We came in off a long way. Just say hi.
And we, you know who sent us up was...
Pat.
Happy boy. Timbo.
Little Timbo sent us over. Little Timbo from the liquor store over there.
Yeah.
Oh, I understand. Well, I'll say hello and see what he says.
We're in the junkyard, man. We got bad dogs. We got Skeeters. We got
get over there, John.
Here, Ben.
Hey.
Randall, get over there by John, by the plate.
We're just getting your license plate down in the picture.
Oh, that's right.
Sorry. Thanks,
bud. Get in the picture now. Get in that picture now. It's your plate.
No good, man.
It's your plate. You got to get in there.
I'm just a
Shelby Robin. What's it with the people from Pennsylvania? Don't they know what they have to do? They didn't get the plate. That's where all the stuff is, right?
I thought we're going to get ripped then, ain't we?
You were worried.
We're staying right here, right? Yeah. Street from the cafe there, and you know, we said Little Timbo sent us over, by the way.
At the liquor store.
Yeah, liquor store. Little Timbo, he sent us over.
No.
Y'all just don't care nothing.
Oh, ma'am, no, we wouldn't
no.
Dream.
No,
absolutely never.
He'd kill you.
Hey, we'd kill
as
anybody. We'd kill anybody to try to tear anything up.
Yes, absolutely. We'll take him in there and show him the trophy room.
Oh my God.
The world's greatest truck driving man over here. Look at
truck
this.
Driving man. Look at this. Truck driving man.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God. Slim. Get the picture with Jesus with Lacy in the truck.
Hey, John, get the picture with Jesus with Lacy in the truck.
Sorry.
That seems temporary, but that is unseen as eternal.
Wait, are they there? They should be in that picture.
Oh, check this out.
Did you get any ideas?
Wow.
Is he?
I'm shaking. Wow.
Oh, man.
Johnston, Larry Johnston.
Oh, man.
Look at Don here, though.
Oh, man.
Matt, our kind of music. That's good.
So family.
Wow.
Beautiful.
Man.
That's
Lacy. Oh, sorry.
Was that
Lacy? Wow. Yeah, let's wait on Tim. Here you go. Sorry, I still have to wait on Tim to show us around. Okay. Well, like I said, we're here with all due respect, and we wouldn't bump, not even bump into anything.
Thank you for inviting us.
Chicago, picnic several years. No. Picnic, several years.
Oh, you been to the picnic?
Several years.
Caps. With guys, you know, the police officers.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
You got that red blue light, that blue light you can put on your truck to get out of
there? No, I haven't got that yet.
Oh, you're not going anywhere.
You need one.
Thank you very much.
Wow. I've got complete chill bumps. I feel like I'm in the church.
I think he's going to cry.
I think he's got to go to the bathroom.
No.
Oh my God, look at this. Who did that, Lacy?
Look at this. Bang
bar.
Who did that, Bang? Look at that.
Up there?
Yeah.
A little girl, 15 years old, up in.
No kidding.
Up in Ditcher.
That's not Judy, is it?
Johnny and Robert.
4 o'clock.
Yeah,
girl. That's Ronnie's oldest daughter.
Wow.
Tammy.
Tammy?
Saw Judy Miller yesterday with us, real quiet.
Show them your free bird tattoo, and Slim, you have to show them when you get a moment your free bird tattoo in the 10/20/77 when you have a chance, Slim.
Wow. How are you feeling?
A little better than.
You look great.
Do I?
Yes, sir.
You don't judge a book for its cover.
Looks good a lot. You look good.
Are you ready for Saturday? Because last year out there in the sun, man, it must have been hot. It must have been hot to sit there all day. Oh, and you had to put up with Collins' mother too all day too. It was fun. A lot of fun. You ready for this year?
At the park, you mean?
Yeah, at the park.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Well, I was autographing books, you know.
You got to snow. Yeah. I'll go run for one.
We have
I'll
one.
I'll go run for you. Whatever you want.
Look at this beautiful picture.
Unbelievable. What a life you've
had. Look at this beautiful picture.
See, every year we bring someone down that's a newcomer. I was there last year. He has no clue what he's in for. This is beautiful.
You've had that shirt as long as you've done faded it out.
That's mine. Look, there's you. There's you right here. That's mine. I didn't wash it. My girlfriend did, but you know.
You know, what we liked it was the picture of you in the 18-wheeler with Jesus by your side. That was beautiful. The painting in the
hand. We got bird shining, right?
I know.
I just can't believe we're here.
Look at this. Look at this.
I can't believe that we're here.
Bobby, you're taking this all in, aren't you?
Oh, yeah.
Look, here's me. Take a picture of me, will you?
Between us all.
Uh-huh.
Take a picture.
Listen, Slim.
This is where Judy got the idea.
I'm
not
giving you shit about that, Bobby. I had to, because that's my nature.
And I said, we was going to buy up all this land out there. And I see, we was going to buy up all this land out here.
Uh-huh.
And this is Plum Millie.
Uh-huh.
Plum out the city and nearly out the county. We're so far back in the woods, our breath smells like horrible.
But you have to carry bricks this time, though, right? No bricks this
no
time.
No bricks to sell, nothing like that.
All right. Brickyard Road, I got one hand.
But we was going to buy up Mull Street, Wharton Street, another street, and one or two more streets over here, all the way back to another street. Tear down everything and move it out.
There you go.
Pick this up and move it over on 95 South.
Do you really have a bad dog, or is that just a lie on the fence? Is there a bad dog here somewhere?
Right in that front. That's my front yard.
Oh, okay. Uh-huh. We didn't see you. Saw fights everywhere. We went all around the block. Looks like about 3 or 4.
We stand about this high.
What kind of dog?
German Shepherd.
They're
the best.
He can't
bark.
He can't even bark.
He's the kind of police use.
Oh, really?
Get out of him. He's a can't bark. Wow.
How do you feed him? You just send people in there.
Trespassers.
go on in the yard.
Lacy, this is Donnie?
Yeah.
With the wig on for school.
Yeah. I didn't get
that was in the scrapbook.
Nice to see you again.
Appreciate
it. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. And you know, we felt bad about it, and Trude and I did, but you know, we said, well, if he was
going to resist, we had to have.
Jimbo,
Timbo.
Little Timbo sent us over.
Tell Lacy put some steaks in
little
the
room
and come on over. He said, no, I wouldn't do that. I go, no, I'm kidding.
Little Timbo.
Little Timbo.
Y'all found him up here?
Yeah, we did at the liquor store over there that he owned his father.
Yeah?
We stopped
him
there.
He was the manager of the band for a while?
Sure.
He said he was the road manager for a while there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wow.
He's a good guy.
I always love the story how Ronnie wanted to move you someplace else and you said, nope, right. Here's where I'm staying.
Look at this, Bob.
I'm trying to get my wife.
That's my idea with St. Pauli girl.
Because I knew it was crackhead neighborhood.
Uh-huh.
And it was
going to
get worse.
Hey, Bobby, look.
And I got that.
Around here.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I got dogs.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right.
And I don't like it. Where I live, I want it open.
Uh-huh.
You know, you're not my door open.
Yeah. Red carpet.
Oh, we appreciate it, sir. We thought we'd see a double barrel shotgun like Ted Clampett there for a moment.
We tell him he's got to go knock on the door.
Yeah, they set me up to knock on the door.
You know? You do it.
We just, you know, we something we hated to do was intrude, but we knew it would be worth it just to be able to see everything, you know.
I just appreciate it.
Here's, this is like, I want you to understand what you're seeing. That's like Ronnie's, I want to
get a, you gotta get the jacket
in that mantle place. Get in front of that mantle.
You got that red blue light, that blue light you can put on your truck to get out of
anything? No, I haven't got that yet.
Well, you're not in a hurry going anywhere anyway. When you're in a hurry, you need one. Thank you very much. This is very, I gotta go to the bathroom.
No. It's not.
Wonderful portrait. Who did that, Lacy? Who did that portrait? Who did that? Who did that portrait?
Up there?
Yeah.
A little girl, 15 years old, up in...
No kidding.
Up in New Jersey.
That looks like that was with chalk or something, wasn't it?
All painted.
Wow.
Look at the
eyes. That hat is, looks better than the real ones.
Wow. Look at Ronnie down here, you know.
Johnny and Robert
are playing.
Play with Zara, had a good time.
John, show them your Freebird tattoo. And Slim, you have to show them when you get a moment your Freebird tattoo in the 10-20-77. When you have a chance, Slim.
How are you feeling?
A little better than a...
You look great.
Do I?
Yes, sir, you
well,
do.
Well, you don't judge a book by its cover.
Looks good a lot. You look
but
good.
Are you ready for Saturday? Because last year you were out there in the sun, man, it must have been hot. It must have been hot to sit there all day. And you had to put up a Collins model too all day, too. It was fun. A lot of fun. You ready for?
What a life you've had.
This beautiful.
See, every year we bring someone down that's a newcomer. I was there last year. He has no clue what he's in for. This is beautiful.
You've had like that picture, Jesus. Year.
Hope we don't pass
this
out.
This is where Judy got it.
Take a picture of you, will you?
Between us all.
Uh-huh. Listen, Slim.
This is where Judy got the idea of the park I have with you. And I see how we was breast smelled like
Jordan. You have to carry bricks this time, though, right? No bricks this
no
time.
No bricks this time. Nothing like that.
All right. Good job.
But we was going to buy up Mull Street, Wharton Street, another street, then one or two more streets over here, all the way back to another street, tear down everything, move it out.
There you go. Mm.
Pick this up and move it over on 95 South.
Do you really have a bad dog, or is that just a lie on the fence? Is there a bad dog here somewhere?
Right out in that front. That's my front yard.
Oh, okay. Uh-huh. We didn't see you, saw fights everywhere. We went all around the block. It looked like about 3 or 4.
We stand about this high.
What kind of dog?
German Shepherd.
They're the best.
I'm shaking.
I know. Yeah, thank you. And you know, we felt bad about intruding on you, but you know, we said, well, we
couldn't resist.
Little Timbo sent us over.
Tell Lacy put some steaks in the grill. We're coming on over. He says, well, I wouldn't do that. I go, no, I'm kidding.
Little Timbo.
Y'all found him up here?
With the liquor store. Yeah,
we
stopped to get some soda.
He was the manager of the band.
We stopped to get some soda.
He was the manager of the band for a while. Sure.
Well, he said he was the road manager for a while.
It's their anniversary, January 4th.
Yeah. Wow.
He's a good guy.
I always loved the story how Ronnie wanted to move you someplace else, and you said, nope, right here's where I'm staying.
Look at this. Bob.
Well, really, I didn't say that. My wife did.
Oh, okay.
Look at this. Look at his shoes.
I tried to get my wife to move out of this.
My idea was St. Paul, girl.
Because I knew it was... crackhead in the neighborhood.
Uh-huh.
Oh. And it's gonna get worse.
Hey,
that's why
Bobby, look.
6 foot fences around here.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I got dogs.
That's right. Mm-hmm. That's right.
And I don't like where I live, I wanna go.
Uh-huh.
You know, you knock at my door, I wanna open it. Go out there and drop it.
Well, we appreciate it, sir. We thought we'd see a double barrel shotgun like Ted Clampett there for a moment.
We tell him he's got to go knock on the door.
Yeah, they set me up to knock on the door.
You do it.
We just, you know, we something we hated to do was intrude, but we knew it'd be worth it just to be able to see everything, you know.
I just appreciate it.
Here's, this is like, to me, Travis Tritt there, that's like Ronnie's little, Johnny and Donnie and Ronnie's little brother there in a way, in a lot of ways, you know.
You know, I'm going to tell you something. And there's a poster that I gave
50 over that.
About 2 years ago. 38 special and Lynyrd Skynyrd in August the 10th of 1976 played at Fernandina Beach.
That's going
to raise money for his brother when he was running for the sheriff of Nassau County. That's the county north of
was that E.C. Van Zant?
That's like
E.C. Van Zant, okay.
That's when he played with Nugent in Chicago, but go ahead.
Yeah. John, you got to get a picture of this.
I kind of got off track. What was that name saying?
About the poster where 38 special and Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Love that picture.
The picture of Donnie in that poster.
That's cool.
It looks a lot like Travis.
Happy
really?
Really?
If you will take a look.
That was on my birthday.
Aww.
And that was in Glasgow, Scotland.
That's cool.
That's Johnny. happy day.
When he gave you the trophy there, that trophy that he had.
You're the one that reviews all this stuff?
My bad. That I see it.
Not a tribute band.
It's a hell of a band, too.
You can feed your dog with that if you don't like it.
It's nice.
You can feed it to the dog if you don't like it.
Oh,
I know he needs to eat.
Well, Lacy, I'll tell you a story about you driving up down the eastern seaboard with Ronnie and the truck saying, shift them here, boy. Listen to that AM country radio, you know.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yep.
Lacy, did Ronnie ever meet Merle? I know Ronnie loved Merle Haggard. Did he ever meet Merle Haggard?
I mean, no. Merle Haggard, I think, was Ronnie's idol.
Was, but he never actually met him?
I guess. I don't know. He loved a lot of, like, Charlie Daniels.
Yeah.
Great buddy. Great friend.
Excuse me?
And, but Merle Haggard. He go up there to his birthday parties. And he came back and told me, he said, you know what, Merle's got to run down through his living room. I said, what? He said, a damn train. A coal miner train.
Right.
He's a little mine.
Right.
Coming down through there.
Uh-huh.
I said, but all that smoke from this back? He said, yep. But he said they had big blowers taking that out.
Suck it out.
Suck it out fast as gun came.
Wow.
Well, I read in that new book, John, you asked about that. In a brand new book on Lynyrd Skynyrd, they just released it, says that because Merle, at the time in 1976-77, Merle was signed by MCA Records, and Ronnie was very excited because he thought maybe
what
they could get a...
What book are you speaking about?
There's a brand new one. It's called Lynyrd Skynyrd and Orphan.
He was drunk and smashed his car. Did you tell Ronnie you couldn't go out with him no more? When he got drunk and smashed his car, he said you can't go out with him no more, did you?
Lacy, you raised Gary, too, didn't you? Just about? And Alan, too?
And Leon.
And what about that gym teacher? Did you ever have to go in there and report to the school and tell that gym teacher to bug off because they didn't wear no socks? You beat his ass, didn't you? I know you did.
Last time I went to see him, I told him, I said, one more trip, and the damn paramedics won't be
all right, Lacy.
The next trip I grab, the coroner's coming.
He said, Ronnie, home. My wife would have to take it. I forgot. It's been so many times to get a haircut. He put him right out of class and sent him home to get a haircut.
This is Charlie's handwriting, isn't it? This is Charlie Daniels? Right here?
That's his handwriting.
Brief candle?
That's what's
he
on
wrote
the
funeral. Right?
That's the one he did.
That's what was engraved in the bench.
He wrote that during the funeral.
Did?
Oh, man.
He's a great guy.
How about the bench? He wrote that during the funeral, too?
That's what he's talking about. That's
what it is.
The bench?
Oh,
that's
it's beautiful.
The same thing.
That's the same thing.
Charlie's a great man.
Charlie is a great man. A great Christian man.
And how many Christian albums he got out now? About three or four or five?
Yeah, we have one called The Door.
The Door.
Very beautiful.
In Chicago, he did a lot of that.
Christian.
And the fans that know him appreciate it was Chicago.
Well, that's all
they don't know. They don't
now,
know Southern rock and roll, but
that's,
I did.
That's all he records now is gospel. So.
Yeah. Now he does,
Listen, when you have a kid, then you know what it's like. I haven't lost one. I lost one cousin.
Some little boy out here. In Alabama, I believe, or West Florida, somewhere, he named his little boy, let's see, it was Ronnie, Donnie, Johnny, Marlene, Darlene.
He named them all.
Darlene,
he
named,
named his little boy with all them names.
Now, who's that?
That's my whole family.
Who's that little man?
Me and my wife.
Who's the little man we just saw? Little
Timbo.
Timbo went out with Darlene or Marlene, that little Timbo guy we saw, the short guy. He said he knew Darlene and Marlene. Now I never heard about that.
So he dated one of them.
I think he dated Darlene.
Did you get this?
She was
no, my camera broke.
That's the reason why she looked crazy there.
Glamorous.
She was modeling.
That's a glamour shot, isn't it?
Yeah.
He did good.
Whose arm is this? You know whose arm that is?
No, I don't.
See the whole band on that arm?
That's beautiful.
That tattoo?
That's beautiful.
It wasn't anything real bad, but that's a queen and that's a princess.
I would, if I knew, I'd tell you. I had no idea.
You can tell you run out of the film or run out of the battery.
If not, I'll send you to your dog, okay?
No, he just said she was pretty. He said, don't say that, you know.
Right. I said, don't do that.
I just realized that we took our suitcases out of the van in the hotel, but you'll be there tomorrow for the picnic, sir?
We're going to play a lot of orders here.
No. Are you coming over tomorrow for the picnic?
At the park. Uh-huh. If it's not raining.
Okay. But, because I want to give you that book. I just left it from interviews. It's not the actual story of Lynyrd Skynyrd. It's just, they start at the beginning, and it just has, it'll say Ronnie Van Zant, and it'll have a statement that he made, and it'll say 1974. And then it continues on. It starts at the beginning, and it goes all the way up to the present day. And it's just a book full of interviews, quotes. It's called An Oral History. It's kind of an orange, kind of a yellow cover. But I promise you that I will give you a copy of it. I promise I'll give you a copy of it. I thought I had it in the van, sir. You have my word. I promise I'll give you a copy of it. We just found them in Chicago. It just came out. Found it in the bookstore the other day. Slim, can I get a picture? Lacy? Okay. Where's Johnny? Where's the video? John, can you get me sitting beside Lacy on the couch here?
But it flew by.
Johnny?
Yes, sir.
Doing something right.
Going over here. What if it rains? What's going to happen if it rains?
Freebird Cafe. It will be in a Freebird Cafe.
Well, will we know in time? We're going to drive all the way out there.
If it's raining, we're not going to go to the...
Can we get him anything? Can I go get you a steak?
For you, Scotty.
Can I make you a steak dinner or something?
No.
I'll make you a steak dinner. What do you want us to get you, man? We got to get you something good.
I'm going to give that book for sure.
Book nothing. This guy got to eat, man. He's got to eat. He's not. We go get you a big steak and cook it for you. This.
On the couch here, I'll get you.
Told me, he said, I'm just short for my weight.
Sure. you ever seen Grumpy Old Man Robbie. Movie? Birds of Sparative. He says, the guy, his brother, his son tries to give him a light beer. He says, light beer, what is this slapping for? He goes, I'm 96 years old. Every morning I wake up, I have a cigarette, I eat bacon. For lunch, I eat bacon. And I usually have a snack for an afternoon, bacon, and then I usually drink my dinner. And I'm still alive.
Yeah,
all those
John.
Guys 30 years old, these yummy bastards are telling me I should be dead in a dirt grave, but I'm
beautiful.
Still
beautiful.
Yeah, press right there.
You're hanging there, man. You're hanging there. But I'm not kidding you.
Okay. Get that small fellow beside of me there.
Don't push him.
Now look how slim he looks.
Don't hug him too hard.
Look how slim he looks.
Are we twin sons of different mothers or what?
How's the weather up there?
I'll go, kid.
One more just to be sure, Slim.
Oh, you are so hospitable. I'm so hospitable.
It's not going to put you if you don't behave.
Yeah, thank you enough, sir. But I promise you.
Thank you, buddy.
One more just to be sure, Slim. I'll get you that book.
Okay.
That's a promise.
Tomorrow we'll see you. What else do you want? Give us a shot list. We're going to give you everything you need tomorrow. Except for a new wife. You stay with her.
Okay. Just goodwill.
Goodwill.
Just goodwill.
You got that. You got that, brother.
Lacy, here's a window sticker.
Good luck to you for the rest of your life, sir.
Some of you can explain that window sticker to him. It's backwards.
I'm sure he can figure it out. He knows what the band name is.
It's the other side, right?
So put it on the inside of the window.
So you put it back,
so
it's looking in the mirror.
So that way,
notice how that bird shines. Look at this bird. Look at this. Look at that bird shines, man. That's a free bird, bro. That bird is alive in this house. That bird is giving off spirits in this house.
Yeah, if you peel it off, this is sticking inside of your window.
You know what? I'm sorry. Do I have a little bit of respect? I happen to be a little bit funny, too.
It costs me a shiny nickel, but you know what? You don't. It's called share the wealth.
Yeah.
The wealth is
those that God gives.
Yeah. It's all about
give.
Heart.
You peel
it's
that
all
off
heart.
And stick that against your window on the inside.
Yeah, boy, that's nice.
It is cool.
We'll bring you some of them over tomorrow and that book also.
This, man?
Now, if it rains, are you going to come up to the Freebird Cafe instead? Yeah.
Unless I piss you off. I won't piss you off tomorrow. I'll buy you Cokes next time.
What's that?
I'll buy you sodas next time.
Don't worry about them.
Well, Lacy, we'll have that book.
Get by that mantle, Robin. Stand by that mantle.
Go ahead, Jake.
Go with him. I love to. I love this woman. You know how special she is? I'm so happy for you guys.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, you guys are blocking.
I've been through women in a year, and I had one that I thought was close to meeting you. I said, no, she doesn't stand next to Robin, so she's got to go. So I brought a homo instead. Smile.
Oh, that's beautiful, man.
It is beautiful.
This whole trip is much better.
This is unbelievable.
Because we're serious. We got a good crew this time.
Yes, we do.
Absolutely. Yeah.
People don't believe it.
Bob, you know, I'll tell you what. Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Johnny,
huge in Chicago.
Absolutely.
They still play them on the radio every day. There's two stations that you can just went back
over
and forth. I guarantee you, within 2 hours, you'll hear a couple Lynyrd Skynyrd songs.
In this house.
I'll never forget when I saw Lynyrd Skynyrd, especially at Soldier Field there, that big show about 80,000 people.
With 10 News.
Oh, yeah, that was
about 87.
Chomp.
Hey,
Gator Country.
Just the Gator.
I win. I want a 5-footer. I want to get a 5-footer.
All right.
Look at this. Look at this.
Day two.
He's got
Sign his name.
102077 on there.
We're all to one.
It's one
to
one. Yeah, who's the one? What's your name, man? What's your name?
Did you see that man's shoulder over there?
Yeah.
Rubber plant, man.
Uh-huh.
Can I pick this up?
Johnny was over there, you know, and he's playing over there.
Look how young he was.
Oh, bring that out, Robin. Yeah,
look how young he was. Uh-huh.
Robin, bring that out over here, son.
Wait, Lacy, can she look at that arm?
Can I touch this? Okay.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have picked that up.
Listen to the story.
Listen. Go.
Okay. Go ahead, sir.
But he heard this noise on the street.
Chills my bones.
And he couldn't figure out what the guy was saying. And he was saying, hey, Johnny, hold it, Johnny. And he had that daggone picture there under his arm. And he was carrying a briefcase or something.
Uh-huh.
And he ran up to Johnny. He said, Johnny, you going home now pretty soon? And Johnny looked at him.
Well, he had on his arm.
We got to play tonight.
Did he?
We
had on his arm?
Play tomorrow night.
Soon
and tonight, we'll pack up and go tomorrow morning.
Uh-huh.
He said, well, I got something I want you to carry home to your dad.
Wow.
I'm
going to text you, Mama. Let's go to
port. Okay.
Okay, let's go. Let's.
Yes.
Miss tomorrow.
Anything you'd like, a gift or something?
No.
Nope.
Are you sure?
Goodwill.
And you brought so much to us, sir. It's an honor and a privilege.
Yeah. One more question for you. Do you have the new book called Southern Rockers that has Ronnie and Greg Allman and Dickie Betts on it?
No.
I got one out in the car of those for sure.
Huh?
For sure I've got one of those. I'll bring it right in now. This one I got in the car.
Got a beautiful cross, too. Beautiful cross.
Yeah.
It is beautiful.
You got one just like mine, haven't you?
Yes, sir.
Pretty close.
You know, the first time we met you, 2 years ago,
you mentioned it.
You really liked this cross. You said, boy, that's a beautiful cross.
Oh, it is. It is beautiful. That was out at the park, weren't
you? Yes.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
You got it back to place.
That's at least. I can do is give that to you. Okay, now you got two of them. That way, if you ever lose one, you've got another one.
That's a great picture, too, of Ronnie.
I love that.
Very good picture.
But, I'll get another one when I get back to Chicago. The other one I will give you tomorrow, sir, I promise you. And it's a very good one because it has a lot of old interview quotes in it.
That's the one I really want.
You've got it. It's yours. I got it in my hotel room, and it's got your name all over it, sir. It's an honor. And a pleasure. Thank you for welcoming us into your house.
Thank you.
And I mean it. It's a dream come true, and I'm not just saying that.
It is. We have seen this in so many videos and stuff. We've seen you sitting in this room and pictures and whatever, and we always imagine what it'd be like to
in our home, to
actually be here.
We have a room for Lynyrd Skynyrd and Ronnie. My husband has
a room.
And he goes out there and he sits and he reads and he feels really nice in that room. But we had to get a house so he could have that room.
Just one room of Lynyrd Skynyrd. He's got posters framed and pictures and just everything of inspiration. We'll love Ronnie and Johnny and Donnie, because my kids, especially songs like "What's Your Name, Little Girl," and all that, they catch right on to that, you know. And they'll hear "Sweet Home Alabama." They'll say, "There's Daddy playing as Lynyrd Skynyrd again." And they're little fellers, and they've heard it so many times.
One of my boys' favorite songs is "Four Walls of Rafer," and he was born. Let's see, he's 21 years old, so that's he was born after.
The next generations will keep on. That music will never die. It will never die. As long as we have kids and they have kids, it's going to keep on going after all of us are gone.
When it touches somebody, it touches them.
Yeah.
You know?
Just like Hank Williams. Hank Williams is still here with me in my heart when I listen to him, you know.
Yeah. Merle Haggard, you know. Merle, he was Ronnie's...
His idol.
Idol.
Yes, sir.
And Ronnie could get a lot of good out of listening to Merle.
Right.
Hours on hours.
Yeah.
And he'd get his guitar down and play a lot of some Merle Haggard stuff.
Mama Tried.
Yeah.
And that song, Mama Tried.
Sing Me Back Home. I'm a Lonesome Fugitive. All those old good prison songs and all that.
Yeah. And Ronnie and Judy. Sometimes you ask Judy when you're out there, hey, what year was it that you and Ronnie went to see Merle Haggard on his birthday party out there?
Turn around. There we go.
Let me see some smiles.
I'm smiling.
Yes, you are.
You want to buy me some teeth?
You don't need any teeth. You can't see your teeth with your beard. You know? Who needs them?
I got mine glued in.
You got yours. Yeah, we're coming out now, Mary. Okay, Lacy, we'll see you tomorrow.
Take care of yourself, okay?
Yeah, okay.
You're going to get some TLC.
Yeah.
She's going to take care of you.
Yeah, God bless you.
You want help up? Why did they have you down so low, man? You need a bigger chair.
I do, don't I?
Yeah.
I'm a bigger man, don't I?
Yeah.
Bigger man.
Yeah, you know what? That sinks you down too low.
It does.
Yeah.
This is out of date stuff anyhow.
But it's cozy, right?
Mm-hmm. Sir, thank you again.
You quit?
Yeah, we had a good time.
A pleasure. I enjoy it when some people come around here.
Yeah.
And
I could smell them boys ate good too, didn't they?
Somebody's a good cook.
Smell them boys ate good here too, didn't they?
Oh, man, I'm telling you.
You don't need any
teeth. We're not worried.
Hey, everybody say thank you, Scotty, to my brother.
Thank you, Scotty.
Scotty.
All right, Scotty.
We love you.
Thank you, Lacy. Thank you, Mary. I'm going to court.